this unit of space, I mean unit of jagat is space. Can you explain a little bit more on that?
Listen, gap between one thought and the other thought is space. Here, gap between one Big Bang, another black hole is space here. Listen, listen carefully. LBD, active. LBD, active. On the space generates time. Anything gets active on the space generates time. Space is the canvas on which all these four exist. Listen. Whenever a mass rotates, it creates gravity. Whenever LBD gets active, it generates time. Where all four exist is space. Because you have space inside, you are able to perceive everything. Because there is a space in the cosmos, all the generation, maintenance, destruction, dilution, liberation happens. The space here, Chidakasa, perceives everything. Space here, Parakasha, allows everything to happen. Little more. Little more. Eyes receive information, digitize it. I should call bio-digitizing. Sense it. It hits at one space and the response comes back. For example, you see the snake, response of let's run away or beat. The spot where this information hits and the response comes back is called space, Akasha. The spot which responds to information is space. If the thought, the gap between one thought and the other thought is too little, you do not perceive the existence of space. If there is a more gap, you perceive the existence of space. It's like a, if you are taking 2,000 files, quickly you have to come back. If you are taking only 2 files, you can spend time with him. Ability to spend time with him is called luxury. Lakshmi. I know. At least you are able to get it, get what I am saying.
That part, but that you said the space between the black hole and the Big Bang. But black hole happens in the Big Bang. Am I correct?
That is why I am saying universe happens within the universe. From the nose of Sadashiva, he breathes out universes. In the mouth of Sadashiva, they all merge inside.
The black hole, that is.
It comes out and goes in. Comes out and goes in. That gap is space.
Thank you, Swami.
Listen. Somebody made this. The effort he put to make this decides how long it is going to retain its shape. That effort is space. For this. Where this information goes and hits and response comes out. That is the space for this. Where all this goes back and comes out is the space for this. Length of this, breadth of this, depth of this. Length of this, breadth of this, depth of this. Length of this, breadth of this, depth of this, I explain. Now the space of this. Energy came out of the space of the individual which is put to keep this in its shape. Is the space for this. If more space is spent on this, it can collapse or remodel itself. Am I right? So that is the space for this. And for this whole, the energy with which it is generated by Sadashiva is a space for this. Based on that proportion of the energy, it exists. If there is some more energy which nullifies this, it goes back, which we call Kali Yuga. I'll give more examples. I'm just translating precisely the Hindu cosmology verses. This has length, breadth, depth. When I move this, it generates time. On which I am moving this is space. Now, if there is no movement, this will stay for more time. If there is more movement, the time of it comes down. But even if there is no movement, the time is going to work on it. It's not that it is exempted from time. But if it merges into the space by samadhi, time cannot work on it. The only thing which has a capacity to merge into the samadhi, space, and avoid time working on it is human being, human consciousness. Too profound. So that is why you feel, oh, it's not imminent. No, it is imminent. Next, I'll make this, make you understand how it is imminent.
That's why the animals, etc., cannot be...
They need to get into the human body for enlightenment. See, the statements I made are literal formulas. Now apply these statements and go on bringing more questions. Once I make these statements fit with your questions, you will understand they are not just profound, they are imminent. They have immediate effect, they have immediate utility value for your life.
Shakti is Devi, it's feminine. Can you?
When I said unit of Sadashiva is Shakti, I did not use it in the language of the Devi which was a form. For her also the unit is Shakti. Understand? Out of clay, the elephant is made. Rat is also made. You can't say the rat and elephant is same. You can say both are made of same material. Now you are trying to say both are same, which is not right.
I was saying whether...
Because the perception elephant generates and the perception rat generates is different. They may be made of same material, but the experience they generate in you is different.
Is the material more feminine?
It has no idea of feminine and masculine. I am not going to be attesting feminist ideas, no. Even though I am a Shakta, the Shakti component does not have idea of masculine, feminine, thank God.
Swamiji, the something else you were saying of the tool to be
see,
in...
listen. The cricketer who is standing on the ground with bat, he is Sadashiva. The guy who is waiting in the gallery to substitute if needed is Avyakta Sadashiva, unmanifest Sadashiva. The power with which he is hitting the ball is Adishakti. Clear?
Thank you.
So yes. Surely, I cannot say Shakti is feminine.
Thank you. The other question was, you talked about being in depth, to be empty and downloading. So is it like a being is like being a conductor where you're not storing? So
I should say, the idea of storing very limited memory is from Google. Your body is not Google. The whole Brahmanda can be stored in Pindanda. Google has a business reasons to give a limited memory. Sadashiva has no business reason to give you a limited memory. Actually, he has all the reasons to give you infinite memory. You do not need to imagine there is a central server. You only live Google and research. I should say the whole cosmic archives is inside. Just your liver is enough to store the whole cosmic archives. If you are thinking your brain is the archives, you are wrong. Brain is a browsing center. Liver is the archives.